Hey, what is going on, guys? It is your donkey back in this video. We're gonna be talking about some new Fortnite update, dude. This is the biggest update to ever come to Fortnite so far. And I'm just gonna say so far because I don't know what Epic Games has down the road. But man, I'm telling you, this is probably one of my most favorite. It is my most favorite game as of this moment, as of honestly the past couple months, and I don't see anything passing it up in summer yet until maybe Red Dead Redemption 2. But anyway, we're just gonna talk about this update. It's all about Fortnite, and the reason why I just did this clip is because I hit my building option twice, and you're gonna basically see what I'm gonna explain real quick. Is I don't know why, but just to let you guys know, if you are, you know, a frequent player of Fortnite, which you probably are if you're watching this video, but it should go unrecommended. I don't know, but basically they have some settings on that they did to everyone that your building does not go back to normal. It doesn't reset, so you're gonna see when I go hit B and then try to hit B again to build, it didn't give me walls and I built stairs and it kind of effed me up. So I was a little bit upset, and I'm gonna show you guys real quick on how to fix that little problem. So just go to your settings, first tab there, scroll all the way down to reset building choice, and then just turn that on. Make sure you hit whatever button it is for you to apply your settings, so and then it does actually be in effect and it actually will work for you the way that it's worked that since the beginning of Fortnite. Now I don't know why they did this, but I guess it's actually really cool for some people and more convenient for how some people like to play. But anyway, we're just gonna get right into this. So they added 5 new spots into the map, and I tried to get a good gameplay clip of each spot, like landing to each spot and getting like a good action-packed gameplay clip. And I'm just gonna say right off the bat, my favorite spot already is probably right here, Tilted Towers. Now they have junk jump yard, man. I already forgot. I only landed there twice because I tried to get one good clip, and the other time I just landed there because I thought it'd be the best, like one of the better, like underrated spots. And it's not underrated, it's kind of rated exactly where it should be. It's right on the edge of the map. It's like running all the way to from Flush Factory to the zone when you land there. And same with like a lot of these new places, since they're all on the edge of the map. Shout out to my friend who I'm playing with right now for actually making that good comparison. Most of these are all on the left side of the map. It's literally, it's a haul to get to the zone most of the time when it's in the middle. But Tilted Towers, man, honestly, a good, I'll give it a 10 out of 10. And even my friend and I have made the executive decision, the one who I'm playing with right now, he's going to probably be the one in Inferno Master 7 who I'm going to refer to every time I say my friend, at least in this video. Maybe not further on in any other videos, but at least for this video, when I say my friend, just think about who I'm playing with in Inferno Master 7, all right? And basically, me and him have made the kind of executive decision on behalf of all the Fortnite community that already landing at Tilted Towers, if you are able to be the one to make it out and kill everyone there and get all the loot, you are going to be set for the rest of the game. That being that you got the guns, you got the ammo, you got all that type of stuff, and you might not have the most building resources, but and then when people start coming in, you're going to already have that firepower ready to just take them out real quick. And it's just basically a great system how that works. And then this clip's just kind of a clip to just show you guys that I don't always win all my gunfights, and I can't clutch up after missing a whole mag of shots just like I did previously in that other clip with the M16 rifle. But basically, also, I want you guys to comment down below your favorite spot to land so far. What's your favorite place? What's your take on the update? And, you know, just your whole opinion on the update, like I said. And, like, oh my gosh, I always repeat myself, I swear. But like I said, I'm going to repeat it anyway. I really do like this update. I like what they did. I don't really think that there's many downfalls on what they did, except for, I don't know. Just everything's on the left side, I guess, is the only downfall I can say, but it's really not even a downfall. That's just kind of an inconvenience to myself and everyone else. Like, everything's on the left side, all these new cities and whatnot, but, you know, like, Retail, Salty Springs, and Wailing Woods, Lonely Lodge, Moisty Mire, all that's still on the right side. And it's kind of weird to look at the color correction, whatever it is, on the map now. This whole left side, and this is also my second favorite place, by the way, to land now. Snooby Shores, I don't know, or Slobby Snores Shores, I don't know why I said it. I think the reason I said it, because if you guys ever heard, you know the song, Slob on my knob, corn on the cob, check in with me. and do your job. Late in the bit. You guys know what song I'm talking about if you ever heard it, but basically that's what this place reminded me of. I thought it was kind of funny, so that's kind of what I call it. I call it Slob on My Knob when me and my friend are already playing, and we've only played 20, about like good 20, 25 games of this, I'd say, and we've kind of gotten a feel for every spot, and I think our new main spot to land, aside from the normal spots being Greasy Retail Pleasant Park, it was Greasy for a while, but I really do think that these Tilted Towers gave a whole new feel to the game. And there's just so many options, so many gun spawns, so many plays that you can literally make there. The circle is it's a perfect place for the circle to end because it's basically directly in the middle of the map. It's next to Loot Lake. It's just, there's so many good variables about Tilted Towers. I really do love how they decided to do that with just build the Tilted Towers there. I think it's probably the best spot they added, not just because I'm being I don't know the word. It's not coming to my head right now. Jeez, school got me fricked up, man. I'm not trying to cuss out here, but anyway, what the hell? No. All right, I'm kidding. Okay, all right, that wasn't funny. Okay, yeah, I get it. No one laughed. No one laughed. I just had to throw this clip in there, though. That dude just got completely fucked. But anyway, even though I just said I'm not going to cuss. But anyway, I just do want to tell you guys, I really like this update. I wanted to show you guys all about this new update, show you everything cool. And you can play soccer now. They have a whole soccer dome. I have a good 10 minutes of me and my friend playing soccer. Of course, there's no voice chat, though, sadly, because I did not have my Elgato plugged in. I normally don't have it plugged in when I play because I don't have an appropriate setup to do that. So I am sorry about that. But I might just be throwing those clips in every once in a while when me and him stop here. They literally made a whole soccer field go past Tilted Towers. And it's like a little... it's a big like building and like a little just part of the land, and it's right there, a big old soccer field. So hope you guys did enjoy this video. Please make sure you like, subscribe, and everything like that. Comment down below what you think about this update, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.